play something for us, D.
All right, here you go. Man, I hate you found me here with whiskey on my breath. I know I should be ashamed, so much for those 12 steps. He said, no, you're wrong. I know you're doing your best with all you've been through. Hey, I understand. I only came to offer you a friend. You know, she still asks about you, wonders how you're doing and where you've been. Tell her I'm in Tampa, on the causeway, watching the waves roll in. Tell her I'm in Aspen, in a cabin, giving myself again. Tell her that I'm happy and I moved on, better than I've ever been. Just don't tell her that you saw me drowning in this bottle, trying to make her disappear. You tell her I'm anywhere, anywhere but here. It would only break her heart if she knew the truth. You see, I told her when she left, this was the last thing I would do. Tomorrow I swear I'm starting over again. I've made it too far and I know where this is, but she doesn't have to find out where I am. If you see or hear from her again, well, tell her I'm in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, selling cars 5 days a week. Tell her I'm in Mobile, Alabama, getting back on my feet. Tell her that I'm happy and I moved on, looking better than you've ever seen. Just don't tell her that you saw me drowning in this bottle, trying to make her disappear. You tell her I'm anywhere, anywhere but here. Whoa, tell her that I'm happy and I moved on, and let her know that I still care. You tell her I'm anywhere, anywhere but here. You tell her I'm anywhere, anywhere but here.
Come on now, that's Mr. D. Vincent Williams. It was worth the wait, man. That's how you do it. That is how you do it, y'all. Tell me a little bit about that song, man. How'd that come about? Who'd you write that with?
I wrote that with me and Wendell Mobley wrote that song back in 19, probably right around 2000, I imagine.
2000. That was a good
19-2000, and that was great. And it actually, we got it cut, and Chris Cagle was putting a new record out. He got on Capitol, and he's putting a new record out, and it was actually the title cut of the album. And something happened to them, the label was waiting to put it out and whatever, and then a guy named Bryce Long came along, and somehow they had put the song out on air on some level enough to where it allowed it to be open to be cut again. And somehow somebody heard that Chris wasn't going to put it out as a single, And so they jumped on it. And then Chris got mad. So that was going to be ours. Not him personally, but the team. And so they both were racing the radio to put it out. And it started getting momentum for both artists. And me and Wendell were like, this is awesome.
Yeah.
And then radio said, you know what? We're not doing this no more. And killed both of them.
Yeah.
So there you go.
I love both versions of the Macarena that would play back in the day.
Yeah, there for a minute, we thought we were the smartest guys ever.
I'm like, yeah, we wrote the same song. Everybody's cutting. That's all you're going to hear is different people.